Hi everyone, this is Veronica and today we are going to discuss a topic that is artificial intelligence. And after this lecture, if you have any queries, you can mail me on my email address, and for my video updates, you can follow me on Instagram and Facebook. So this is a channel StudyIQ. If you guys are preparing for any government job, be it SSC, bank or UPSC, we have our pen drive and tablet courses. For additional information, you can call on these numbers or you may log in into our website. So before starting the discussion over this topic, I have included some questions for you, and I really hope that after this lecture you will definitely try answering these questions, because usually I receive a lot of mails and messages where students ask me to discuss the strategy to write answers. So I will say the more you practice, the more perfection you'll gain and you won't face any problem on the day of examination. So after this lecture, please try to answer these questions. So I'll just read out these questions for you. Does AI, AI is artificial intelligence, poses a threat to the existence of human race? Discuss critically. Next is, should India embrace AI in governance? In GS3, it can be asked like, what do you understand by the term artificial intelligence? Give an account of its potential utilities for the mankind. And in the ethics paper, it could be asked like recently there was a debate going on by the Elon Musk and Mark Zuckerberg. Tech entrepreneur Elon Musk had said artificial intelligence, that is AI, poses an existential challenge and fundamental risk to mankind, while Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg maintains that Musk's predictions as imaginary fears and AI has potential to make world a better place to live in. So what is your stand on this issue? You can discuss whether left, right or center. You can answer accordingly. And for the essay, I've already made a video where I discuss the strategy to write essay for the examination. And for essay, I usually say you don't have to read anything extra. Whatever you're reading and preparing for your GS papers is building up your base to write essay in the main examination, right? So here essay topic could be like artificial intelligence, an end to human miseries, or an end to humanity itself. So it is something like this question only. Here you have to write in 200 words and here you have to write between 1000 and 1200 words. So write accordingly. And for prelims, I have again considered one question. Consider the following statements. First statement is, artificial intelligence is an intelligence showed by machines. And second statement is, the term artificial intelligence was devised in 1956 by John McCarthy. So you have to select the correct options from these four options. And please write the answer in comment box after watching this video. So before starting this lecture, I have included these two posters, one of Small Wonder. This was one of the serial on Star Plus during our childhood days, where this girl was a robot, human-like robot. And same concept was built on Indian television on Karishma Ka Karishma. And today, this is somewhat a reality. Our technology has reached to this point where today, this is turning into reality. Now, recently, why AI is suddenly in so much news? Because recently, this robot, Sophia, that is the first robot to be granted citizenship by Saudi Arabia government. Sophia is basically a humanoid. Human means obviously human beings, and oid is like similar. That means this robot is similar in appearance to human beings. That is why it is known as humanoid. Now, Sophia is a humanoid robot that is developed by Hong Kong-based company Hansen Robotics. It has been designed to respond to questions and has been interviewed around the world. In October 2017, the robot became Saudi Arabia citizen, the first robot to receive citizenship of any country. So this Sophia was basically activated on 19th April 2015. Okay, so this robot is modeled after actress Audrey Hepburn, okay, and is known for its human-like appearance and behavior compared to previous robotic variants. According to the manufacturer David Hansen, Sophia uses artificial intelligence, visual data processing, and facial recognition. Sophia also imitates human gestures and facial expression. Like here you can see her face is quite happy and here a sad face. So yes, she can imitate facial expression. Sophia is also able to answer certain questions and to make simple conversations on predefined topics. Like here I've included one of her answer in one of the interviews. She was asked like, if robots will destroy the human race, then this robot has also shown sense of humor, where she answered, you have been reading too much Elon Musk, because I recently gave you a question also on the first slide where I said there's a debate between Elon Musk and Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg. So she said, accordingly, you have been reading too much Elon Musk and watching too many Hollywood movies. Don't worry, if you're nice to me, I'll be nice to you. So putting this conversation here, I mean to show you that this humanoid has sense of humor also. Now its designer, her designer Hansen, said that he designed Sophia to be suitable companion for the elderly at nursing homes or to help crowds at large events or park. He hopes that robot can ultimately interact with other humans sufficiently to gain social skills. So now let's discuss, what is artificial intelligence after all? So to make it simple, artificial intelligence is intelligence exhibited by machines. Artificial intelligence is intelligence that is displayed by machines, in contrast with natural intelligence that is displayed or exhibited by humans and other animals. So in computer science, artificial intelligence research is defined as a study of intelligent agents. Any device that perceives its environment and takes actions that maximize its chance of success at some goal. Colloquially, the term artificial intelligence is applied when a machine mimics cognitive functions that humans associate with other human minds, such as learning and then problem solving. Okay, so now here I also said, in the prelim question that I gave in the first slide, prelim based question, the first statement was this only. The term was coined in 1956 by John McCarthy at Dartmouth conference at MIT. So you need to remember this, and now you can attempt that question also. Now we'll try to see some examples of artificial intelligence that we use in our daily life. Let's take the first example, that is virtual personal assistants. Now you have heard about virtual personal assistants. For example, Siri, Google Now, and Cortana. These are available on the platform. Siri is available on iPhones, Google Now on Androids, Cortana on Windows phones, right? Now in short, they help, this artificial intelligence system help find useful information when you ask for it using your voice. You can say like, where is the nearest restaurant, what's on my schedule, anything. You can tell them to remind you to call someone specific at specific time, and the assistant will, this assistant, that is the artificial intelligence technology, will respond by finding information, relaying information from your phone, or sending commands to other apps. Now AI is important in these apps, as they collect information on your request and use that information to better recognize your speech and serve you results that are tailored to your preferences. Now, Microsoft says that Cortana continually learns about its user and that it will eventually develop the ability to anticipate users' needs. Virtual personal assistants process a huge amount of data from a variety of sources to learn about users and be more effective in helping them organize and track information. See, next is video games. One of the instances of artificial intelligence that most people are probably familiar with is video game. Artificial intelligence has been used for a very long time, since the very first video games in fact. But the complexity and effectiveness of that artificial intelligence has increased like exponentially over the past several decades, resulting in video game characters that learn your behaviors, respond to stimuli, and react in unpredictable ways. Next is smart cars. You probably haven't seen someone reading the newspaper while driving to work yet, but self-driving cars are moving closer and closer to reality. Google's self-driving car project, you might have heard about, and Tesla's autopilot feature are two examples that have been in the news lately. Earlier this year, the Washington Post reported on an algorithm developed by Google that could potentially let self-driving cars learn to drive in the same way that humans do through experience. Okay, next is security surveillance. A single person monitoring a number of video cameras isn't a very secure system. People get bored easily, and keeping track of multiple monitors can be difficult even in the best of circumstances. Which is why training computers to monitor those cameras make a great deal of sense. Of course, the number of things that these computers can catch is currently pretty limited. Seeing flashes of color that may indicate an intruder or someone, loitering around a schoolyard. Identifying actions that might imply a thief in a store are likely beyond the current technological limitations. But don't be surprised if this sort of technology debuts in the near future. Next, you might have seen such kind of systems in music and movie recommendation. So let's discuss a little bit about this. While they are rather simple when compared to other AI systems, you might have heard about some apps like Spotify, Pandora, Netflix. They accomplish a useful task, recommending music and movies based on interest you have expressed and judgments you have made in the past. By monitoring the choices you make and inserting them into a learning algorithm, these apps make recommendations that you're likely to be interested in. Let's move to the next slide. Purchase prediction. Large retailers, you all are shopping through Amazon, Snapdeal. Now these are the large retailers like Target and Amazon, stand to make a lot of money if they can anticipate your needs. Amazon's anticipatory shipping project hopes to send you items before you need them, completely obviating the need for the last minute trip to the online store. While that technology isn't yet in place, brick and mortar retailers are using the same ideas over coupons. When you go to the store, you're often given a number of coupons that have been selected by a predictive analytics of algorithm. Okay, next is fraud detection. This is very important. Now, have you ever gotten an email or a letter asking you if you made a specific purchase on your credit card? Many banks send these type of communications if they think there is a chance that fraud have been committed on your account and want to make sure that you approve the purchase before sending money over to another company. Artificial intelligence is often the technology deployed to monitor for this kind of fraud. Now here I have included this picture. Let's see the speed of fraud detection. We blink eye in 300 milliseconds. Google gives its search results in 200 milliseconds. Radar rotation is 185, happens in 185 milliseconds. And see, the speed of this fraud detection by artificial intelligence system is taking only 40 to 50 milliseconds. Okay. Now, next example is online customer support. Many websites now offer customers the opportunity to chat with a customer support representative while they are browsing. But not every site actually has a live person on the other end of the line. In many cases, you're talking to a rudimentary artificial intelligence system. Many of these chat support bots amount to little more than automated responders, but some of them are actually able to extract knowledge from the website and present it to the customers when they ask for it. Okay. Next is news generation. Did you know that artificial intelligence programs can write news stories? The Fox, Yahoo, all use AI to write simple stories like financial summaries, sports recaps, fantasy sports reports. AI isn't writing in-depth investigative articles, but it has no problem with very simple articles that don't require a lot of synthesis. Automated Insights, the company behind Wordsmith software, says that e-commerce, financial services, real estate, and other data-driven industries are already benefiting from the app. So, what you need to know is your smartphone, your car, your bank, and your house, all you use artificial intelligence on a daily basis. Sometimes it's obvious what it's doing, like when you ask Siri to get you directions to the nearest gas station. Sometimes it is less obvious, like when you make an abnormal purchase on your credit card and don't get a fraud alert from your bank. AI is everywhere and it's making a huge difference in our lives every day. So, a true artificial intelligence system is one that can learn on its own, just like human beings. True AI can improve on past errors and it gets smarter and more aware, allowing it to enhance its capabilities and intelligence. That is what a true artificial intelligence system should be. Now, in this slide, I have included some banks which are also using artificial intelligence system in their banks for to serve customers in a better way. This example is firstly from HDFC Bank and then SBI Bank. HDFC has Era and Eva. Era is intelligent robotic assistant and Eva is electronic virtual assistant. Now, what are the functions? Era can guide people at a branch to find a relevant counter for them, and Eva can answer common queries of users who log on to bank websites. The objective of HDFC is to offer services, interfaces and products in a way that customers can interchangeably consume them through any digital channel. So basically they are getting digital. SBI is using SIA, S-I-A, that is SBI Intelligent Assistant. It is helping customers with everyday banking tasks. Okay, and there was a robot Lakshmi which was first among such kinds that was launched by Kumbakum based City Union Bank artificial intelligence powered robot, and it was first on-site bank helper. And now after all these, here we have Sophia, and we have almost discussed about her. Now, as I told you, excuse me, there is a debate going on whether artificial intelligence is good or bad. So let's see the pros and cons of this technology. So firstly, we'll discuss the applications of artificial intelligence system. Now see, we'll discuss it sector wise. First of all, health sector. Machine learning is being used for faster, cheaper and more accurate diagnosis and thus improving patient outcomes and reducing cost. For example, IBM Watson. Okay, and there are some bots. Such tools are already in use. Next is business sector. To take care of highly repetitive tasks, robotic process automation is applied, which perform faster and effortlessly than humans. Further, machine learning algorithms are being integrated into analytics and CRM platforms to provide better customer services. There are chatbots. Next is education sector. This is very important. AI can make some of the educational processes automated, such as grading, rewarding marks, etc., therefore giving educators more time. Next is financial sector. It can be applied to the personal finance applications and could collect personal data and provide financial advice. In fact, today software trades more than humans on the Wall Street. Legal sector. Automation can lead to faster resolution of already pending cases by reducing the time taken while analyzing cases, thus better use of time and more efficient processes. Manufacturing sector. Here, robots are being used for manufacturing since a long time now. However, more advanced exponential technologies have emerged, such as additive manufacturing, that is 3D printing, which with the help of AI can revolutionize the entire manufacturing supply chain ecosystem. There could be intelligent robots. Robots can perform the tasks given by human because of sensors to detect physical data from the real world, such as light, heat, temperature, movement, sound, etc. Moreover, they have efficient processors, multiple sensors, and huge memory to exhibit intelligence. Okay, gaming, I already told you, in video games. Now there is speech recognition. See, there are intelligent systems that are capable of hearing and grasping the language in terms of sentences and their meanings, while human talks to it. Like I told you, virtual personal assistants like Siri, Cortana, Google Now. And in the end, there is cybersecurity. In the 20th conference on e-governance, even in India, it was discussed that AI can provide more teeth to cybersecurity and must be explored to its greater potential. So this was about applications of this technology. Now let's discuss some of the downsides, because as an educator, I will show you both the sides of this technology, positives and negatives. What are the applications and what are the downsides? So in the end, you have to make an opinion how you will write in your exam. So here we'll discuss some downsides. The decrease in demand of human labor. See, due to machines and intelligent robots taking over the jobs in the manufacturing and the service sectors. For example, in China, some custom officers are now robots. In Japan, robots as housemaid is emerging trend. So people will lose employment. This is one of the concern. Now, existential risk. Stephen Hawking has once said, the development of full artificial intelligence could spell the end of the human race. Once humans develop artificial intelligence, it will take off on its own and redesign itself at an ever-increasing rate. Humans who are limited by slow biological evolution couldn't compete and would be superseded. So such kind of concerns are being shown by scientists also. AI technology is falling into terrorist hands, okay? May unleash modern terror network, include machine, and therefore vulnerability of humans may magnify. It may lead to moral degradation also, because today we are surviving on human to human interactions. So it could even lead to moral degradation of society due to decreased human to human interactions. And for these random queries, in such an era of rapid and disruptive changes, many questions also arise. Will these technological changes be accompanied by equally profound economic, social, and cultural changes? Will technology destroy jobs at faster rate than the rate of creation of jobs? Will future governments be forced to fork out universal basic income? How could education be redefined with artificial intelligence, big data, augmented reality, and personalized learning pathways? Next could be, are conventional manufacturing plants under threat with the advent of additive manufacturing? What will be the impact on skills required? After all these changes, people-to-people communication and socio-economic activities remain the same. So these are the large concerns expressed by the people who are against artificial intelligence technology. Okay. Now, let's see in Indian context, AI applications in Indian conditions. See, it can complement Digital India mission by helping in the big data analysis, which is not possible without using AI. Targeted delivery of services, schemes, and subsidy can be further fine-tuned. Smart border surveillance and monitoring to enhance security infrastructure. our country is too much dependent on monsoon. So weather forecasting models may become proactive and therefore pre-planning for any future mishaps such as floods, droughts, and therefore addressing the farming crisis, farmer suicide, crop losses, etc. Even disaster management could be handled faster and more accessible with the help of robots and intelligent machines. And here at Smart Border Surveillance, in the counter-insurgency and patrolling operations, we often hear the loss of CRPF jawans, which can be minimized by using the robotic army, lesser human personnel. Moreover, AI can be automate government processes. As I said, should, in one of the questions I asked you, should we adopt AI, should we embrace AI in governance, that is e-governance, then I think yes. Now, you can write the answer according to you, because AI can be used to automate government processes, therefore minimizing human interactions and maximizing transparency and accountability. It can be applied to study ancient literature in the remotest areas where the last leg of governance is almost broken. AI can do the job. For example, the tribal areas and the hilly areas of Northeast. So these are the applications in Indian context. Now, which is the agency in India which is promoting research in this field? So that is Center for Artificial Intelligence and Robotics. That is a primary laboratory for DRDO for research and development in different areas of information ICT, and this is located in Bangalore. So it is involved in research and development of high quality secure communication, command and control and intelligent system. So you need to remember the name of this Center for Artificial Intelligence and this agency, laboratory basically. So next we'll discuss the conclusion. Like in the answer, when you've written both the sides and you need to conclude, and I always suggest the people who ask me that your conclusion should be optimistic. You should never be negative, because AI is coming and we can't stop it, but we can make it safe. So you have to answer like it's only a matter of time that machines will replace most of the jobs. This is a concern, but it does not mean the end of road for humanity. Like people, we have seen that by technological revolution, earlier we used horses to ride, to go from one place to another. Then cars came and horses lost their job. But human beings are not horses. We will find new ways for employment. See, there are endless possibilities for the application of artificial intelligence, but the ethical and moral concern emanating from it cannot be brushed aside also. The recent debate needs to find its way to larger public discourse, where all the stakeholders of the society can discuss and understand the possibilities that AI as a scientific innovation holds. So the speculations about job losses because of AI can be turned around by learning from history, wherein revolutionary concepts have usually led to the creation of new set of jobs. Machines cannot mimic the human brain's ability to think uniquely and come up with new solutions to problems every time. In future also, this human ability to make sense of novel situations and experiences would help in regulating AI. So that concern is also balanced. In the next, you can write, to preserve the significant values of humanity, a regulated application of the new technology is needed to prevent its transformation into any draconian concept. So you can always write a positive conclusion like this. Next, I've included this picture I really liked, where myths are given at this side and the facts are given this side. So I'll read it out for you. Super intelligence by 2100 is impossible. So it may happen in decades, centuries, or never. AI experts disagree, and we simply don't know. Only Luddites worry about AI. Fact is, many top AI, like I told you, Elon Musk researchers and Stephen Hawking, they are also concerned about AI. AI turning evil, AI turning conscious. So basically, there is nothing like this, but yes, it can get misaligned. If we have there is a machine and we have assigned it a goal A, it might shift to the goal B. So it can misalign with our goals. Robots are the main concern. Misaligned intelligence is the main concern, as I discussed here. AI can control, can't control humans. So I must say, intelligence enables control. We control tigers by being smarter. Machines can't have goals. Then you should know, a heat-seeking missile has a goal. Super intelligence is just years away. It's at least decade away or maybe centuries, but it may take that long to make it safe, because our concern, we should not panic, we should try to regulate AI, and we should always write a optimistic conclusion. So if you have any queries regarding this lecture, you can mail me, you can message me on Facebook or Instagram, and I'm really happy to attend your queries. They help me grow and learn also. So keep messaging, keep mailing. Thank you.